It's a great time to spend some time grabbing hold of a lifeline to peace of mind. And we'll do that right now. We are full members in good standing of God's great country club, reality. God made us members, lifetime members, eternal members of this country club. Beautiful, wonderful place. And the great thing is that we cannot resign from this country club. We cannot be disqualified. Why? Because God does not accept our resignation, our disqualification. God sets the rules for our membership, and it's His decree, God's decree, that we're members, eternal members of this club. We can never be disqualified. Okay? Very important. God sets the rules for us. It's not up to us to set our own rules. We cannot go to God and say, God, we have resigned from your club, and you have to accept our resignation. God says, well, I don't accept it, because I'm the one who made you a member, and only I set the rules. It's my club, so I decide who's a member of my club, and you're a member. And you can deny it, and you can reject this, etc. It has no bearing on the fact that you're still a member, eternal member. You can never be disqualified. So, here we are in this world. What are we doing? We're trying to set up our own country club here. We said, God, we're going to set up, we're going to make a better club than your club. We're going to make a more beautiful country club. And we're going to be happier there than we are in yours. Just, you know how kids want to do something and then that their parent isn't involved in, saying, we can do it better than you. We don't want you to help us. So we said, Prime Creator, we're going to build our own place, our own home, our own country club, and we don't want you helping us, have any involvement in it, and we're going to make it even better. It's going to be a better place. Well, it's turned out to be a bitter place. So I'm down here, you know, I come into this world, and I try to tell people, hey, folks, what are you doing here? You're already members of God's Country Club, okay? And so you don't remember that? And everyone says, no. No, we're not. Okay, here's the problem then. Everybody here claims they're not members, I say. That's nuts. How can you say that? And they said, well, I resigned long ago. I resigned from that club. Or I was disqualified. I say, what are you talking about? Says who? And he says, well, God told me this. Really? I say, really? Is that true? And I'm starting to scratch my head. Something's cuckoo here. I said, no. You cannot be disqualified. God did not disqualify you or kick you out of the club. They say, oh, no. We're bad. We did something bad, and well, at the very, very best we have it, maybe we're on probation. I say, no, there's no probation. You cannot, you're full membership, irrevocable. So then there's an argument here. And basically, just sheer numbers caused me to, quote unquote, lose the argument. Not any reason caused me to lose the argument, just sheer obstinacy, stubbornness, obstinacy, and numbers, and intimidation, and all that. So finally said, wow, what's the problem? Some kind of problem, huh? Actually, there is no problem. Now, what I found out is that everyone in this world they believe they have to go through a qualification process. Who set up this qualification process? It's not God. Checked in with God. God's not paying any attention to any qualification process. And yet we have this vast qualification process, and we're all working on that frantically. And when I tell people, hey, what are you doing? You're already qualified. You don't need to go through any qualification process. They get upset and say, you're wasting my time. I'll never make it if I don't keep working really hard to qualify. I say, okay. So what do I see metaphorically here? I see this, let's say there's this beautiful country club, lush green grass and flowers, and it's just gorgeous. And then in front of this club, there's this guard shack, security checkpoint. Big sign saying, stop, halt. All vehicles must come through here. And there's gates everywhere and stuff. So I get in line, I get up there, and the guard says, okay, what's your name? They say, okay, what we're doing here is we're checking your status to get into this God's Country Club. And what's your name? Tell them my name. And they look, check, and say, okay, well, yeah, you have potential. It shows right here. You show up. You got potential, but you got to develop that potential. I say, let me ask a few questions. I say, I'm going to ask a few questions of you. Where did you get this list? I say, and the guard says, well, God gave me the list. I said, really? And said, who's doing the ranking? And they say, well, God's doing the ranking. I say, really? And who's giving the advice of what kind of things I need to do to develop my potential? And again, the guard says, well, God gives us all this. God's in charge of this security checkpoint, in charge of the rankings, the listings, everything. I say, really? That's very interesting, because that's not at all how I understand it. And so I get out of, I say, okay, next, and I'm out of the line. And everybody's going through the security checkpoint, and I go back and I start thinking about this whole situation. I said, this is very strange, because with my experience with the Prime Creator, there's no such thing like that at all. No hint that the Prime Creator set up some security checkpoint to get into his country club. No sign of any need to qualify. We're all pre-qualified because he made us members. He created us and made us full membership. So I say, where in the world is this coming from? Well, this is very important to hear. God did not set up this checkpoint. What we call the ego or the devil has set it up. The liar, the deceiver. And we'll talk about where that liar deceiver came from. Because really, we wanted to set up our own country club and make it better. Better than God's. And so we set up this checkpoint also in front of God's country club and staffed it and made lists and made advice and all of this. And then made big signs. Everyone must go through here. God's decreeing this. We set it up for the purpose of delay so that we would continue to work on our country club, building it, step by step building it. So everyone that goes through the security checkpoint, they're told, well, you got potential, or you got some problems, or you really have a lot to work on, or you're very high on the list, but you just need to do a few more things. And so then we go back, and what do? We ask, well, what do I need to do to qualify? And we're told, well, you need to go build more churches, more temples, more places of worship. You need to build more hospitals, more schools. You need to do more charitable works. You need to become a more loving person. You need to work on all this stuff. And we say, wow, okay, it sounds like, yeah, that sounds like something God might say. So we'll go work on that. And so we work on that, and then we die. Everybody's working on all these ways to qualify. And so I'm this lone voice here sitting here saying, wait a minute. I think there's something messed up about this whole situation entirely. And then I'm explaining this. We set this checkpoint up. So after very careful and lengthy consideration, I see the entire situation for what it is. It's a complete scam. Now, there's this roadway to the side of this checkpoint, and there's no checkpoint there. And there are cars. Sometime a car drives up, goes straight in to the country club. And we wonder, wait a minute, they didn't even go through security checkpoint. Who are they? And the security people say, well, they finally qualified after long, long efforts. They were able to qualify, one of the few rare qualifiers. I said, really, I'd like to speak to one of these qualifiers. So I did. Spoken with some of these who go straight in. I say, how did you qualify? You know, what is this? And they say, no, I didn't qualify. I'm pre-qualified, and so are you. I say, what? What are you talking about? They say, yeah. Everyone is pre-qualified. God created us all members of the country club. Irrevocable, eternal members. We don't have to go through any qualification process. This whole qualification process is a scam. That we are scamming ourselves is just a delaying tactic to keep us slaving away and trying to build a better country club so that we can stay there. It's just pride, spiritual pride. And so they say, all you need to do is just drive right in. As a matter of fact, here's the key to getting into the kingdom. You simply walk right in. That's the key. You know the story of St. Peter at the gates, the pearly gates. How do you get past St. Peter? Very simple. You simply walk right in. How do you not get in? You ask St. Peter to see if you're on the list. Because by asking... by asking, am I on the list? That automatically shows that you believe that some are not on the list, which means you're setting up your own rules for God's kingdom. You believe it's your rules, not His. That there's a qualification process. You believe there's a way to be disqualified. See? And so you, again, are projecting your rules on the situation, and so St. Peter will say, no, you're not on the list. You can't get in. Okay? The way to get in is simply to walk in. Don't ask any questions. Don't say, am I on the list? Because that means you don't understand the situation at all. And therefore, you won't be able to get in. Because you'll insist that there are some who can get in and some who cannot. Which is not true. Everyone is already pre-qualified. There's no such thing as any list. There is no list. God knows that all that God created is full membership, eternal full membership of the kingdom. Therefore, what does God need a list for? Does God need a list? A list is to show who's on it and who's not on it, right? Everyone is full membership, eternal membership. So there's zero need for any list. There is no list. So when you get up to St. Peter and say, St. Peter, check the list, you're obviously insane. You don't understand the situation. So you're trying to still disqualify yourself, which means you cannot function appropriately there. You'll be wondering, well, why am I here and others are not? I have to go help them qualify. That's the problem. There is no list. There is no advice to qualify. Everyone is already full membership. Just walk in. Does a full member, eternal full member of a club, do they go through a security checkpoint and say, am I on the list? No, they just drive right in. Member's entrance. You know, there's a sign saying, member's entrance. and the other on the side, there's a security checkpoint to see if you're a member. But the trick is that you're already a member. Anyone who's going through that security checkpoint is still caught up in the pride of trying to build their own separate country club and trying to make it better than God's. And they want to keep telling themselves that they're not qualified for God's country club, kingdom of heaven. So therefore they have to keep working on this one. It's just a delaying tactic of pride, spiritual pride. And I say, why don't you just go into God's country club and experience it? And they say, no. Why? Because they would know it's so much better It's perfect. And this one that we're trying to build, it's terrible. And I'd probably be stung, you know. It's like, wow, we didn't do a very good job. Why, of course, we're trying to exclude God. How can we exclude God? We're one with God. We have to think we're separate. In order to exclude God, we think we're separate. We can build a separate country club, separate kingdom. And we don't want to even pay any attention to God's kingdom, because as soon as we do, we'll realize how perfect it is, and we say, oh, I want to go there. And we'll stop working on trying to qualify. And we're afraid of that. They think, oh, the only way to get there is to qualify. That's a lie. That's a lie that we're telling ourselves. And all the lies we tell ourselves, we call that the ego. But it's not really any ego there. We're the ones who are telling ourselves these lies. There's no devil or Satan or ego telling us. We're telling ourselves these lies. Out of our own pride, we want to try and build a better kingdom where God is not allowed. And we claim that God is the one that is sponsoring this. And we hide what we're doing by claiming that we're trying to qualify for God's kingdom. And the lie is pointed out by anyone who says, no, you're already pre-qualified. What are you doing? I hear people say, the way we have to be is to try and learn to be more loving people. Okay, what are they saying? Why don't you just enter into the kingdom? You're already a member. They say, no, we're not loving enough yet. We need to learn to become more loving people. That's trying to qualify. What they're saying is, I'm not yet qualified. I need to keep working on qualification. Which just really means I don't want to experience God's kingdom, because if I did, I would give up my efforts to create a separate kingdom. That's what's really being said. That's hidden under these spiritual platitudes of saying, no, I'm just trying to be a more loving person. Okay, that's nonsense. That's how we avoid experiencing the kingdom. I have experienced the kingdom, which is why I know, wow, so much better than anything we can ever build. It's perfect. It's a waste of what we're doing is just a waste of time. And yet we are trying to sugarcoat it and put bows on it, bows and ribbons on it, and say, no, God is helping us build this great kingdom here. And he's giving us advice on how to do this. Nonsense. That's like saying we go up to the line to get in and say, how qualified am I? And the ego says, hey, you know, you're up here pretty high on the list, so you should just have, you know, a little bit more work you need to do, and maybe you need to go learn to, you know, need to learn to be a more loving being. That's what the ego will tell us. And we say, okay. All right, I'll work on that. And again, we reject any notion of just walking into the kingdom and experiencing it. Because we know we would instantly fall in love with it and say, I'm never going to leave here. This is perfect. And we give up our attempts to create a separate kingdom. We know that deep down. We know that. So we keep playing this game of qualification, the qualification game. Go up to the security checkpoint. We say, am I on the list? Can I get in? They say, you're a probationary. You can't get in yet, but you've made a lot of progress since the last time. So congratulations, and here's some advice to work on. So you see how absolutely simple this whole situation can be shown to be. So easy to realize what's going on if we put it in this sort of framework. And that's the right framework to put it in. Really, really and truly have to put it out of the framework of qualification, which is where the whole world is setting. The entire spiritual discourse on this planet is put in the context of qualification. Everybody is intensely interested in, how do I qualify? And so I'm saying you have to change the entire context. There is no qualification. You're pre-qualified. So simply walk into the kingdom. No security checkpoint. Why? Is God there at the gates of the kingdom saying, okay, who checking in everyone's ID, who gets in and who doesn't? No. God knows everyone that God created is pre-qualified. Why? Because God qualified them. That's why. God's law and word is law, is the rule in the kingdom, not ours. There isn't a separate set of laws for us. We've just imagined that there is. And we can't go to God and say, God, some are qualified and some are not. That's our rules. Our rules don't apply to God. God is the one that sets the rules. So we're under no rules except God's rules. Therefore, we're pre-qualified. And we absolutely are entitled to this eternal full membership. It's impossible to disqualify ourselves from this. It's eternal full membership, meaning you cannot disqualify yourself from it. So many are down here screaming, oh, I'm so bad, I've done so many bad things. And I've disqualified myself. I talk to them and they say, no, I can't possibly be disqualified. Look at all the terrible stuff I've done. I say, no, you cannot disqualify yourself. You've done all these quote-unquote terrible things in an attempt to disqualify yourself so that you could then work full-time on trying to create a separate kingdom without being disturbed by thoughts of maybe you could, you know, return to the kingdom. That's what it is. It's all a scam, what we're doing. Again, the victimization thing, where we think we've done bad things, etc. It's all a sophisticated scam, where we believe we can disqualify ourselves. And we don't need to dwell too much on that, because it's upsetting to people, because that's the cornerstone of the whole situation here, is guilt. And saying, guilt says, hey, I've done wrong. No way can I be a member in God's kingdom. No way can I have membership. I must have, you know, been blacklisted. I have black marks on my membership. I have to re-qualify. Not true. We have complete, full, eternal membership in the kingdom from the very beginning. Irrevocable. No such thing as any black marks on it. Why? Because God said so. So who are we to claim otherwise? That is the question. We're trying to assert that what we decree is greater than what God decrees, can countermand what God decrees. We say, it's like we go to God and say, God, you say that we're eternal full members, but you don't know what we've done. You see, we've done some bad things, and so we're not eternal full members. We're on probation now. So we're decreeing to God counter to what he decrees, which is, you know, spiritual pride. And repentance means to realize that God's the one that makes the rules, not us. God's the one that makes the decrees, not us. What God decrees is the way it is. We cannot countermand it. And yet, we're insisting that we can countermand it. And we say we've done all this bad stuff, and God just shrugs and says, whatever you think you've done doesn't change my decree one bit. Your eternal, full membership, impossible to disqualify yourselves. Why? Because that's how I created you. That's my rule. That's my decree. And plus God says, there's nothing in the kingdom that can be harmed in any way. So what is this guilt you're talking about? And we say, well, yeah, but in the kingdom that we set up, we, you know, attacked all sorts of things and destroyed all sorts of things. And God says, well, you set up this imaginary kingdom where everything's vulnerable. So then you can then pretend that you can destroy things and pretend you can do all these wicked things, etc. But it's just a pretend, just a pretense. It's all symbolic. You haven't touched my country club at all. You haven't caused any problems here at all. In fact, it's impossible to do so. So you're simply trying to countermand my reality that I set up. It's not possible. never will be. And so you have this, you know, situation that we are arrogantly asserting that what our decrees are greater, counterman God's decrees, which is just sheer arrogance, which again doesn't disqualify us. We cannot be disqualified, no matter how great our arrogance, saying we can create a separate kingdom, and that the what happens in this kingdom, the vulnerability of this kingdom, somehow disqualifies us, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Those are simply fantasies, decrees that we're making, laws that we're making, strange alien laws that have no bearing on reality whatsoever, none. And then we try to tell God that, no, God, you have to qualify us because we're disqualified, so you need to set up a whole system of qualification. God has not done any of that. We've just pretended that God has because we want it to be so. So we think, we believe, we have faith that there's this vast qualification system, a vast spiritual path that we need to tread, and that God has set all this up through God's grace to save us, you know, to qualify us. Not true. We've set it all up to delay, to, you know, so we can continue to entertain our vast pretense that somehow we can disqualify ourselves and that God's rules don't apply to us, that all the rules that we've made up are greater than God's rules pertaining to us. There, God didn't set up any path to qualification. None, because God knows we're already pre-qualified. If God set up a path, that would countermand God's decree that we're pre-qualified. And we'd believe that, oh, we're not pre-qualified, we need to qualify. We've set that qualification system up entirely. That is why I say simply, forget about all that. Just walk directly in. You don't need to show any ID. You don't need to show any qualification. You don't need to say I've had, you know, 50 lifetimes and I'm a really loving person. Nobody's there asking you any questions about your qualification. Because as soon as you enter the kingdom, everything's perfect. And you feel the perfection. And you're blissful. You forget all about all those things you tried to do to qualify. You forget about what a loving person you are. None of that has any bearing whatsoever. Reality is completely flawless. Can never be a flaw there. So what is qualifying has no meaning. The more we think we've qualified, the more barriers we've put in our own way of looking at it. We've got all these medals and look at all these qualifications I have, you know. And you walk up to the heaven and say, I want to present these to God. And we can't find God. Where's God? And God's not interested in our resume. Really. There's no one in the kingdom to check our resume. No one pays the slightest attention to any resume. And we get scared thinking, oh my gosh, I must not have qualified because no one's interested in my resume. I better go work on it some more. No. What need is there for us to present a resume to God? God's the one that created us. He knows we're pre-qualified. He pre-qualified us. So we don't need any resume whatsoever. What kind of resume could we possibly present? There's no paperwork needed. There's no selection committee. There's no one saying, okay, you need to present your credentials and we're going to consider your membership request. No committees. Just absolute, immaculate freedom. You're full member. You know, full membership means you tee off whenever you want to. You're free. You have free privileges. Full privileges. Don't even need to make a tee time. Go to the restaurant whenever you want to. You know, you got full qualifications, full trust. Kingdom of Heaven's like that. You're completely free. No, there are no checkpoints, no ID checks, no resume checks, no demerits, no concern that you might do something that'll disqualify you. So from time to time, there are those who come from the kingdom into this world, appear here, and they just remind us, hey, everyone, you already have full membership. Give up all this effort to qualify. That's what's blinding you. You're trying to heal something. What is sick? The only thing that's sick is the idea that somehow our laws and rules that we've made up countermand truth. That's the only thing that's sick. That's all that we need to give up. We need to give up believing that we can qualify. We're pre-qualified. The arrogance is that we need to qualify. Who made the rule that we need to qualify? We made it. That's arrogance. Because we say our rule that we have to qualify is countermands, is greater than God's rule that we don't have, that we're pre-qualified. So there's no qualification necessary. That's the problem. So we need to start looking at the situation from this angle. Because that's the problem. That's the only problem, is our arrogance. That our rules are somehow greater than God's decree. And then when God decreed that we're all eternal full members of the kingdom of heaven, that somehow we decreed that we're not, that we have to go through a qualification process. That is the only problem there is, that we have. And we start looking at it in this context, you will very immediately, you realize, wow, I'm not that far off from walking into the kingdom and enjoying the full privileges of the kingdom. But you're fabulous. And you realize, wow, I don't, you know, I'm right here at the point of consideration. And I don't need to go anywhere else. I'm very close to simply walking on in. Forget about all this qualification process I've been immersed in for so long. Forget about these gurus checking my resume saying, well, you're kind of strong here, but you're not so strong over here. You need to balance this out. You know, you need to develop your personality, develop your spirit, develop your soul. You need to find your soulmate. You need to be more loving. You need to get rid of guilt. You need to do all these things, you know, on and on and on and on forever, right? Some vast, vast swamp. If you look out, it's never-ending qualification process, jumping through so many hoops, going up the spiritual corporate ladder. And now you're sitting here and you realize, well, wait a minute, I don't need to do any of that. I'm already pre-qualified. All this stuff was just my arrogance. I wanted to try and build a separate kingdom because I wanted to pretend to be prime creator myself. I didn't want to be co-creator with the prime creator. I wanted to be prime creator. So I needed a separate kingdom where I could act out this fantasy. And in order to do that, I had to set up this sophisticated system that made it look like I am not a member of the kingdom at all. And so all this pre-qualification nonsense, just nonsense. I've always been a member of the kingdom of heaven. Full membership. Eternal membership. Everyone. No one who is not a full member. So I don't need to go save anyone. I don't need to qualify anyone. I'm not some, you know, guru who's saying, okay, here's how you qualify. You know, you need to chant this mantra, you need to do this and that, and you need to examine how you react to people and how you treat people. You need to get over, you know, change your personality and, you know, on and on and on and on. No. That's all totally beside the point. That's all comes from your arrogance that you want to create a separate kingdom. That's how you delay. That's how we delay so we can keep working on our separate kingdom. Again, if we get a taste of the kingdom of God, will very quickly give up our work on a separate kingdom because we realize that this place is just a garbage dump. No matter how we configure it, it's a garbage dump. You go to the most beautiful place on this planet, it's a garbage dump. Nowhere you can go in this world, it's not a garbage dump. Piece of junk, worthless piece of junk, it's nothing. You get just a taste of the kingdom, you'll know that right away. So, in our arrogance to want to try to be prime creator, we're desperate not to get any taste of the kingdom, to block it out entirely. And of course, we want to taste it, because we say, you know, boy, I really miss my home, my club. And so how do we prevent this? By this massive ruse of, you know, channeling that desire to experience our home, our kingdom, where we're full members, channeling that into trying to qualify for it. We say, yeah, sure, we need to experience it, that'd be great, but we can't do it because we need to qualify for this experiencing first. As we said, we've set up this vast qualification process to simply distract us away from actually just walking and experiencing it. Again, what badges does a full member need to show? Nothing. God knows we're full members. Doesn't not asking us for qualifications. Simply walk in. Nobody's there to stop us. There's no barrier at all to the kingdom. None. Zero. There's no gates. No security checkpoints. Because God's the one that sets the rules. God knows we're all full members. Cannot be disqualified. So what security checkpoints could there be for? Well, for what? We're the ones who have set up all these barriers. God has set up no barriers whatsoever. Zero. We're the ones who have set up all this progression. We're all progressives. You know, we're all buying into this out of sheer arrogance that we need to make progress in some way. What relevance does that have to our full membership? We're already perfect full member, eternal full members of the kingdom. Progress has nothing to do with that. So when one is talking about progress, first ask, well, are you experiencing the kingdom of heaven right now? And if you're not, then you must believe that you have to make some sort of progress in order to experience it, which again is arrogance, because it's denying what God has decreed, God's laws. So, teaching in this world, reassuring, is a very simple, very simple thing. Incredibly simple. Just simply say, you're pre-qualified. Walk on in. That's it. You know, when you go to a really beautiful place in this world, let's say, and you walk there, and you experience, you know, like the Yosemite or something. You know, we're affected by it. We say, oh, wow. Doesn't matter what kind of person we are or whatever, the grandeur is there. We experience it. We're affected by it. It's the same way in the kingdom of heaven. You go in and you just say, wow, it's perfect. It's flawless. Nothing here can be contaminated or corrupted. And you say, my gosh, if I dwell here, I will feel immaculate. I'll feel fabulous. This is totally blissful. Automatically. Makes no difference what you thought of yourself previously, or what your personality was, or who you considered yourself to be, or what your qualifications were, you know, whether you're depressed or angry or, you know, grouchy person. None of that has anything to do with it. You automatically will feel this complete refreshing bliss. You know it can never be harmed or changed in any way. So that's why in our arrogance to try and establish a separate kingdom, we're desperate to avoid simply experiencing the kingdom. Because we'll automatically then know none of this pre-qualification stuff is all nonsense. Again, that's why Krishnamurti said, truth is a pathless land. There's no path to truth. You're already pre-qualified. You don't need to gain all these ranks and statuses, orders, initiations, all this nonsense. That is what you have to drop. And you drop it all at once. You don't need to drop it bit by bit. Because it's all just a pretense. We wanted to pretend that we're prime creator. So of course we had to try and divert our desire to experience the kingdom into the channels of qualifying. That's exactly what we've done. Everyone is already pre-qualified. That's why you get these great teachers, these great reassurers. They look on everyone the same way. There's no judgment. When we talk about judgment, what do we mean? We mean that they're looking upon everyone as they know they're looking upon a full member of the kingdom. Everyone they look at is already pre-qualified. They know that. Impossible that it be otherwise. And no one is greater than anyone else. They know everyone has full membership. Equal. Perfectly equal. So they look at everyone that way. And they chuckle and they laugh when people come and say, oh, you're so fortunate to be a member of the kingdom of heaven. How can I qualify? You know, and they just they just laugh and they smile. And someone says, you know, I want to meditate and I need to do this and that. Well, a lot of times they don't disagree. They just say, well, okay, meditate some more, clarify some more, because it's very tough for people to hear that you're already a full member. You don't need to do anything. They equate that with failure to qualify, right? If you take someone who totally believes in qualification out of severe arrogance and pretense that they want to set up a separate kingdom, okay, so they want to divert their experiencing of the kingdom into qualification. So they're really intent on qualifying. And if you just tell them, oh, give it all up, give all this qualification up, you don't need it, they'll be terrified. They'll say, oh my gosh, I'm never going to qualify. If I give it up, I won't qualify at all, and I'll, you know, it's the worst thing possible. So the gurus, you know, just say, well, okay, you know, continue your qualification, just do more of it, and more of it, and more of it. You got 8 hours, do 10. You do 10, do 15. Do 15, do 20. Work harder at it, work harder. So they can say this, but eventually the person is working more and more and more. They go, oh man, I'm so tired. Oh, I'm not getting anywhere. This is terrible. You know, just what's the problem? You know, and gradually, then the truth will start to dawn. But you can't really take someone who's invested in qualifying and tell them to drop it entirely. You can say it, but they're going to reject it. Because to them, that's to lose status. In really, the way it's set up is the higher status we get in qualification, the more one believes that they don't really need to experience the kingdom. They use that status as thinking, ah, I'm at such high status, I can use it to build a separate kingdom even more effectively. So it's kind of a trap, actually. Sort of a diminishing returns thing. So the higher you get up in so-called qualification, the more then there's a tendency to think, wow, I'm so high up in qualifying, I can spend my time helping others qualify and be real preeminent advisors how to qualify, which just intensifies the delusion. So the wise guru will simply say, you know, tell them to work themselves harder and harder and harder until finally the wheels come off and they say, forget it. I don't want any more of this qualification stuff. And then the guru says, well, that's okay. You're already pre-qualified. There's a famous story of some Tibetan, was it Milarepa or some Milarpa or something. Where this Tibetan disciple goes to this Tibetan guru, and they say, "I really want to qualify. You know, I know that you can help me qualify for the kingdom." So, and the guru says, "Okay, not a problem. I want you to build a stone house right here." And the disciple says, "Wow, that's a lot of work." And the guru says, "Yeah, if you want to qualify, you got to do it though. You got no choice." So the disciple says, "Oh boy, okay." So the disciple carries stone by stone by stone, heavy labor. They build this stone house, really nice house. Took me a couple years, you know, of heavy labor. So the guru comes back and looks at the house and says, "Wow, you did a great job. Beautiful home. There's only one problem." And the disciple says, "Yeah, why, what's up? I need to make some little change, or what's up?" And the guru says, "No, you built it in the wrong place. I told you to build it over there." And the disciple says, no, you told me to build here." The guru says, no, I did not. I told you to build it over there." And the disciple says, wow, I really messed up." So the disciple then, stone by stone, carries all the stones over there. Rebuild takes 2 more years to rebuild the house over there. Does a great job. Guru comes back, looks at it and says, "Fantastic. You really built a great house. But you know what? I don't like this location. It's not really what I wanted. I want you to move it over there." Oh my gosh, the disciple's really upset. And say, "Well, all right, I'll do it one more time." So he moves the whole house again, a couple years more. Guru comes back and says, "Wow. You know, it's a funny thing, but it just this doesn't suit me. I want you to move over there." Okay, the disciple again does it. And his disciple's moving all these stones, is so upset and so tired, and get furious at the guru and says, "You know, you're just jerking me around. This is crazy, you know. I'm not gonna do it. I mean, I don't even know why I'm doing this in the first place. It's nuts." And the disciple, you know, rebels and says, "Nah, I've had enough of this qualification stuff. You know, it's all nonsense. You're just a joke." And the guru says, "Yeah, you're already pre-qualified. You didn't need to do any of this." Disciples enlightened just like that. Ah, so I see, it's my own pride. I insisted on that I could pre-qualify myself. My rules, not God's rules. And now I see, it's God's rules. God decrees that I'm pre-qualified. What arrogance I had to think I could qualify myself. So that's why the gurus work in mysterious ways. They know you're already pre-qualified. But right now, you're not asked to go through that whole song and dance of building stone houses and then moving them and moving them again and again and again. Okay, we don't need to do that anymore. We can directly look at the situation. This world got a great boost by A Course in Miracles. Not that you need to study that necessarily, but it was a way of directly looking at the situation through the eyes of reason. Being able to see the situation, so we don't need to spend lifetimes in contemplation, lifetimes trying to please a guru, trying to qualify. Can drop the entire thing, the whole fast fantasy, fast system of arrogance, of distraction, of pretense. Everyone is already full eternal members of the kingdom of heaven. No one can ever be disqualified in the slightest bit. That's all we need to know. There's nothing we can do one way or the other that has any relevancy to that fact. Again, we're dealing with fact. pretension. We can't change fact. God determines what is factual and what is not factual, not us. And that is the only thing we need to know. We are under God's rules and laws, not our own. So we're entitled to walk right into the kingdom, because that's God's rules and God's laws. We're full members from the very beginning, always and forever. That's fact. So if we want to continue to deal with fantasy, you know, we can. But it won't change fact one bit. Then that result will be the same. One day you will finally just walk right into the kingdom and say, to heck with all those ridiculous qualifications, nonsense. That was only my own. I was trying to set my own rules. So teaching can be very simple if we have done our homework and studied. And I can tell you from studying the Course in Miracles for a long time and applying it and trying my best to understand it, that it's gotten me to this point. And then also leaning on the reassurance of several great gurus, especially Sri Anandamayi and Raman Maharshi, relying on their reassurance that they were here and they pointed out the truth of what A Course in Miracles is talking about, that they looked at everyone as equal members of the kingdom of heaven, because they knew that they are. We all are. They're not looking down at anyone. I saw that. I saw it as a fact. Did Anandamayi Ma ever look down on anyone? No. So that tells me, she knows we're all equal, full members of the kingdom of heaven. No such thing as qualifying. There is such a thing as remembering, though, of this fact. So the real spiritual path is remembering what is already true, what's already a fact, and then really giving up our own rules and our own pretense and fantasy, and accepting that it's God's the one that makes the rules, not us. So if you can combine a very direct teaching that's based on the reason, looking, pointing out what must be true, and you combine that with a great reassurer, or reassurers who show you, who showcase the fact, what is true. Did Ramana Maharshi ever look down on anyone? No. He looked at everyone, equal vision. Vision, he said, I'm looking at a full member of the kingdom just like me. Perfectly aware of that. So you get that reassured. They don't have to say anything. They can, but the reassurance is very important. Combine the two of those, and you're able to clear away the cobwebs. Which is what we're doing right here, clearing away the cobwebs. And we're doing it just in time, always. I have a curious trait that I'm always on time for some reason. Always timely, so very soon the cobwebs will get very, very strong in this world. And everybody will be frantically involved in dealing with their status and their qualification. And they'll really be into a whole state of very strong forgetfulness. We don't want to go there. We want to go to remembrance. And it's a great blessing that we have tools to work with here. That is what I'm saying. For instance, A Course in Miracles, that's just one tool. There are others as well. But a direct approach through reason. I'm able to speak with reason, through the eyes of reason. So there's another help here. And then there's reassurers, great reassurers, who look on everyone with equal vision. Maybe there's some in the world right now, I don't know. There certainly were a couple in the 20th century. Ramana Maharshi and Anandamayi Ma were definitely that way in Punjaji. And there are others too. There are others. So, we can use these tools. These are tools. You have a toolkit, a direct exposition through reason, and a reassurer. But those two tools, you can remember the truth, the fact. You can remember what's a fact. Realize then, you don't need to go through the security checkpoint. Just drive straight on in. Full membership. It's funny because I hate the idea of going to a country club and, you know, check in. Got to check in. Are you on the list? On the guest list? All this stuff. I always want to just drive straight in. That's my feeling. I say, I'm a member here. How can you say I'm not a member? Well, of course, in this world, it's all about keeping people out. But in the kingdom, we're all in. All of us. And we may say, well, I don't want such and such to be a member. I want to keep them out. But I want to speak to this point very carefully here. Because, of course, we all feel that way. We have preferences, personal preferences, who we like and who we don't like here. But everyone that enters into the kingdom of heaven automatically feels this perfection and bliss, and they become immaculately wonderful. All personality traits vanish. So there isn't anyone in the kingdom that you dislike. In fact, you look at everyone and they're so wonderful. But there's no way we can get that feeling here in this world, and trying to learn that is a complete waste of time. Because everyone here has preferences, everyone has a persona's characteristics and qualities, etc. Adapting, responding, adjusting to this fake kingdom that we've tried to make here. There's no way anyone who says they can love everyone here from this within this context is completely arrogant. Someone like Ramana Maharshi, they're coming from the context of seeing everyone is a perfect member of the kingdom of heaven. From that fact, that is what they're looking at. They're not looking at our personalities or judging things that way at all. That's totally irrelevant to them. But we're trying to learn to love all personalities equally, which is nonsense, complete arrogance. We can never do that, and that's not the point anyway. That's still an attempt to establish a kingdom here by saying, oh, this kingdom here is equal, just as good as God's kingdom, because everyone's equal here, we're all members and we all love each other, blah blah. You know, that's still trying to establish a separate kingdom and just trying to make it perfect and refusing to experience God's kingdom, which we'll realize is perfect, has always been perfect, and will always be, remain so. So this is, I feel very confident this teaching is right on the mark. Feels that way to me. I mean, I'm listening to this, my own teaching here, and saying, yeah, this is exactly what I want to hear. In other words, I'm giving the teaching that I want to hear. So I absolutely believe in this teaching. And I say, yeah, this is what I want to hear. This resonates, pure resonation with truth, with fact. And I do read The Course in Miracles a little bit now. It's been a long time since I have, maybe more than 15 years. Because I was trying to let it settle down and simplify within me. And now when I go back and read it, I say, yeah, what I'm saying here certainly is right on the mark. Again, we're totally entitled to the kingdom because we're under God's laws and God's rules. God's rules apply to us. And that's why we're totally entitled to the kingdom, because it's God's rule and law that we're full members. Always been, always will be. So we absolutely are entitled to that, to just walk right in. The more we hear that, the closer we get to doing it. We're certainly not going to do it if we're told something different. We have to qualify. Then, of course, we're not going to just walk right in. We'll be frantically involved with qualifying. And the problem is that this world is going to go through so many changes now that our entire qualification process is going to be thrown into chaos, you know. We're going to freak out. Those people who believe they have to qualify are going to freak out very soon. And they're going to jump into cults, where somebody, qualification cults is what I call them. Or they're desperate, say, oh, you know, everything's changing, I'm going crazy, what's going on? You need to really help me qualify. And then, you know, they'll nominate a cult leader who will then have them, you know, jumping through all sorts of hoops. Don't want to do that. There's no cult here, because saying you're already pre-qualified, you don't need to do anything. You don't need to please me, you don't need to please anyone else, ever. You're, from the very beginning, you're a full member. Equal to me, equal to everyone else. Equal to the Buddha, equal to Jesus, equal to Nanamayama, equal to Ramana Maharshi. They're full members, and you're a full member too. Everyone is. Cults arise when people are involved in trying to qualify, and they nominate some person who's some expert at running this qualification game. Tell you the truth, the cult leaders, they don't even like doing it. After a while, they say, boy, I want out of this. But the members, the ones who are trying to qualify, are desperate to have someone give them the advice they want to hear. So they nominate some charismatic qualifying guru who then tells them to jump through these hoops. They say, you need to learn to love me better, you need to worship me, you need to glorify me, you need to meditate more, you need to be a better person, you need to treat others, you know, on and on. And they say, oh, thank you, we will bow at your feet, you're the greatest, you're the king of the kingdom, you're the ultimate, you're the God, you know, all this stuff. That's a cult, that's nonsense. But people are going to jump into that because their whole qualifying process they're used to is going to be messed up very soon. Really, it's already getting messed up. But people are heading into situations, a very tribal type of situation, where they each will cleave to somebody that they believe will help qualify them. But here, there's no such thing. As I'm saying, you're already pre-qualified. There's absolutely nothing you need to do. Nothing you need not to do. You simply need to remember this fact. Now, there's a certain decorum in any situation where there's someone who is reassuring you of this fact. Then there's a decorum, of course, of people being respectful of this reassurance. In other words, not acting out, blocking others from hearing this. There's simply a decorum. Why, you watch Krishnamurti, there's a decorum there. Nobody's worshiping Krishnamurti. He's not putting himself ahead of anybody else. But he's the speaker. He's reminding us of this fact. We're all equal members of the kingdom. And because he's clear about this fact and others are not clear about it, it's right decorum is to be respectful and quiet and listen to this and not disrupt. That's simply, that's all there is a simple decorum. Krishnamurti showed us, very great teacher, that's underrated, undervalued. He gave us talks, very simple, no grandiosity, simple decorum. Everybody there understood, okay. Here is a brother who's a full member of the kingdom who's reminding us that we're full members too, but we have forgotten this and we're denying it. And we're full of all pretense, and so we need to be quiet and respect and listen to what he's saying so we get it. So everybody came, sit down, very quiet. Nobody's saying, oh, I need to touch your feet, I need to throw myself at your feet, I need to compose poems about you and you're so great and all this stuff, you know. No, that's not it. Now, some gurus allow that because that's the tradition, that's the culture of people who want to learn. They think they need to qualify. They think they need to do all this stuff. So they give some allowances for that. But here, right now, these times, simple decorum is all that is required. But that is required, simple decorum. You don't have people shouting insults or acting out, or on the other hand, you don't have people acting up either. Like, oh, we must all jump up and scream and praise you and all this stuff. No, simple decorum. Let's listen. That's the simple decorum. Let us listen. So the speaker is in a place where people can see them a little bit and listen to them. It's a point of focus. That's all. Speaker is speaking, we're listening. That's the decorum. The reassurer, the reminder, is reminding us and reassuring us. So let's pay attention. That's all. There's a spirit of paying attention. In any genuine situation, there's a spirit of paying attention. And that's it. That's the spirit. That's the attitude. Let's pay attention. Let's be calm. Let's be attentive. Because what we're hearing is that we're already full members. We don't need to continue on with this charade of qualification. It's all a charade. It's all a waste of time. So let's not waste any more time. And we really don't have much more time to waste, because again, everyone who believes in qualifying for the kingdom is going to be faced with a really, really severe consternation coming up. Really. And they're going to cleave to tribalism and cults. All the while shrieking, of course, that those who are not doing that, they're the ones who are going into cults. That's what they'll say. That's why anyone who's simply reassuring and saying that everyone is already pre-qualified, people will claim, oh, you're trying to start a cult, you're a cult leader, etc. They're just projecting their own feelings of missing the boat. Because they're the ones who are going to jump into cults, cults of qualification cults, we can call them. Demanding that they have, you know, leaders, tribal leaders and tribal committees that will keep vetting them and set up a new system of qualifying, because this system of qualifying is falling apart, it's going to fall apart. So they will demand that they have new qualification standards to be set up, new leaders, etc., etc. So they're the ones that are going into tribalism and qualifying cults. We're the ones who are not doing that. We're the ones who have finally seen through this charade, and through the wonderful help of the tools that we have gotten and utilized. We're blessed to realize the facts that it's God's rules, not our rules. God's rules that we're pre-qualified. There's nothing we need to do to qualify. Period. That's a fact. So all we have is simple attentive decorum. Decorum towards attentiveness. To be reminded of this fact. That's it. All right. Wonderful. Right on time. This clarity has come out right on time. Very great. That's it for this video.